Hi, my name is Richard Whitt, and I'm a fellow with the Mozilla Foundation. I'm a former public policy attorney with Google, and currently have my own foundation called GLIA, which is intended to bring more choice, autonomy, and freedom to the web. So today, we have what I call three kinds of artificial intelligence platforms that are intertwined with our daily lives. One is what I call the online screens. The second is the environmental scenes, the devices and sensors around us. And the third is the bureaucratic unseens happening in situations that we don't actually have transparency into. Here today, we're going to talk about the first two of those. So the first kind of AI sits behind the screens we use every day. For example, Facebook or Twitter, YouTube, but really hundreds of websites. These AIs suggest a variety of things to us, from articles to read, to videos to watch, even who we should be dating. The second kind of AI is a more recent phenomenon. So these are the devices that are placed in our environments. So we have virtual assistants like Apple's Siri or Google Assistant or Amazon's Alexa. They reside on devices, typically in our houses, even our living rooms and bedrooms, or on our mobile devices, or even on our bodies. Now these virtual assistants are powered by very advanced forms of artificial intelligence, which allows them to respond to our commands and even offer up their own suggested actions at the same time. So there's no doubt that these virtual assistants have a lot of utility for us in our lives, but the question is, who are these AIs really working for? In both of the cases I've described, the screens and the scenes, the companies who are creating and employing these AIs want to make us believe that they are operating in our interest. The reality is somewhat different though, because these are large corporations, right? And they operate under the paradigm of selling things. So they vacuum up our personal data to share with third parties you've never heard of, advertisers, data brokers, marketers. These systems are also not built well to accommodate the needs of every human being. So the result of these systems tends to be inherent bias. How can we make a future basically where these assistants are answerable to us? I believe that answer is something that I call a personal AI. A personal AI simply is very similar to the artificial intelligence, based virtual engines I described earlier. There's one major difference, however. These AIs have been programmed to represent us as individual human beings to protect and promote our interests and not the interests of these large corporations and governments. They are intended to have no conflicts of interest. There's an overriding imperative for companies to make money off of us. That would no longer be the case. Nor could they be easily hacked by kind of shadowy third parties out there who are looking to steal our identities. Instead, they use machine learning to assess what we actually want and then take steps to make it happen. They can protect our privacy and our security and our identity at the same time by promoting our best interests online. They can tell Alexa, okay, stop collecting data for the recommendation engine and instead let my personal AI have access to the data itself. So maybe my personal AI can create my own curated feed of content on my terms. Let's say you're visiting a friend and they've got an Alexa or some other kind of digital assistant that's sitting there in the living room. As you knock on the door and you walk in, it's trying to collect data about you. Your personal assistant can basically direct the other assistant in this case not to collect data, for example, not to activate the camera so it won't use facial recognition. So there are a number of ways that we can improve the chances for this kind of future to happen. The technology itself, ironically, is largely there. The bigger questions come around in terms of the market. Who's going to provide these services? Who will pay for them? There will be resistance from the platforms. It's probably inevitable that they're going to not want to connect their AI networks to somebody else's or respond to the personal AI. So that, in fact, requires some uniform standards. And then finally, ultimately, it may be law and policy. I would ask your elected officials to require two things we don't have today. One is a right to delegate, which is essentially the idea of having a third party that you trust making these decisions on your behalf, and the platform company has to therefore obey their instructions. And the second would be what I call a right to query. So my personal AI system should be able to interoperate, essentially talk to the other systems, and then question and then challenge and otherwise help to alter the consequential decisions that these AIs are making about your life.